When we talk about atoms, there's usually going to be two kinds of masses that we're going to be talking about. One is going to be the mass of a single atom. The other is going to be the mass of lots of that atom. Now, that seems like it's going to be the same thing. But the distinction is, I can talk about my weight, and then I can talk about the average weight of a human being. That's a distinction that we're making. Single atom, average weight of all of the atoms. Those are the two that we're going to talk about here. Now, atomic masses. When we look at the periodic table, for carbon, we're going to find that the atomic mass is listed as 12.011. That is going to be the average mass that we're going to find occurring in nature, on Earth, under normal circumstances, etc., etc. You will find other average masses of carbon other places in the universe. Not because there's something weird happening or something very esoteric happening. We're just saying that different places we might have different ratios of all the isotopes. Some places may have been radioactively active for so long that things have degraded. Other places may be fresh enough that there's still lots of these radioactive isotopes around. Now, a mass number is going to be for a certain isotope, and that's when we would see something written like carbon 12. And if you remember back for our notation, we said that the 12 tells us this is the total number of particles inside of the nucleus. Carbon tells us that there are going to be 6 protons in it, which means we could actually go ahead and write the number 6 in there if we really wanted to. And then if it had a charge, we'd put a charge here. We're not worrying about charges for this one. Now, all isotopes of a certain element are going to have pretty much the same properties other than their mass. So in your body right now, you've got some carbon 13. It's just a tiny, tiny bit radioactive. In other words, every now and then it's going to degrade and it's going to kick out a particle and its weight is going to change just a small amount. We can have ones where it changes quite a bit as well. But in this case, there was a ratio of carbon 12 and carbon 13 made originally whenever the carbon atom was being generated, probably in a star or whatever. Now, over time, that ratio changes, which means that if you measure how much of carbon 12 and carbon 13 you've got, you should be able to tell how old something is, which is known as carbon dating. That's just looking at the differences in individual isotopes. But I really want to hammer this hard. Isotopes are the weight of a single atom. Multiple isotopes of the same atom will behave pretty much the same way. But when we start talking about more than one atom, now we're going to start talking about averages. Now it turns out that these isotopes are going to have certain natural abundances under normal circumstances. And so in nature, carbon 12 is going to make up just about 99% of the atoms that you're going to find. Carbon 13 will make up another 1% or so. And then carbon 14, carbon 11, 10, 15, all these are going to be in trace amounts. Some of these will be in the parts per million or parts per billion or even trillion or even more rare than that. Because it turns out there's only certain spots that are stable when you make these. So, turns out carbon 12 and carbon 13 are the most stable of these forms of carbon. They appear a lot in nature. So if you grab a chunk of charcoal and it's made up of mostly carbon, notice that the average mass of the carbon in that charcoal is going to be 12.011. That tells you right away, most of it, just like we expect, is going to be carbon 12, 99% of it or so. About 1% of it is going to be heavier at carbon 13. Now suppose that you did a weighted average of those two things. And so you took the weight of 12 times the percentage in decimal form, carbon 13's weight times its abundance in decimal form, and you do that over and over for all of the naturally occurring isotopes. What you're going to find is going to be the atomic mass that you find here on the periodic table. So, for isotopes, we're going to be seeing this number. For big piles of the atom, we're going to be seeing that number. Make sure that you keep those two distinct in your mind. So the atomic mass of carbon is going to be 12.011 AMU, atomic mass units, or Daltons. That's another unit that we'll use for it. We'll find out why later in the course. We'll also see that AMU is sometimes capitals, sometimes it's lowercase. There's no distinction being made there. Just sometimes people write it all caps, some people write it all lower, and either one of those are going to be correct for our course. Now, by definition, carbon 12 weighs 12 Daltons. Every carbon 12 atom is going to weigh 12 Daltons, and so it's going to weigh 12 AMU as well, because they're really the same thing. There's some very subtle distinctions in those two units, but that goes well beyond the scope of this course.